We're given f of x equals 3x minus 6, and g of x equals 2x squared plus 7x plus 5. We want to determine each of the following. We first have f of 7 plus g of 5. To evaluate f of 7, we want to determine the output of function f when the input is 7. So we'll substitute 7 for x in function f, and then for g of 5, we want to determine the output of function g when the input is 5, so we'll substitute 5 for x in function g. So for f of 7, we would have 3 times 7 minus 6, plus for g of 5, we'd have 2 times 5 squared, plus 7 times 5, plus 5. And now we'll evaluate each expression and then find the sum. So here we have 3 times 7, that's 21, minus 6, that's 15, plus, here we have 5 squared times 2, that's 25 times 2, or 50, plus 35, plus 5. So f of 7 plus g of 5 would be equal to 15, plus 15 plus 35 plus 5 is 90. 15 plus 90 equals 105. So f of 7 plus g of 5 equals 105. Next we have f of 3 minus g of 2. So now the input into function f is 3, and then the input into function g is positive 2. Once we find these values, we'll then find the difference. So for f of 3, we would have 3 times 3 minus 6, and then minus g of 2, which would be 2 times 2 squared plus 7 times 2 plus 5. So for f of 3, we'd have 3 times 3, that's 9, minus 6, that's 3, and then minus, for g of 2, this would be 2 squared or 4 times 2, that's 8, plus 14 plus 5. So this would simplify to positive 3, and then minus 8 plus 14 plus 5 is 27. And 3 minus 27 equals negative 24. For our next example, we have f of x plus g of x. Notice how we're not given an input for the functions, which means when we find this sum, this will give us another function. So f of x will be the quantity 3x minus 6 plus g of x, which will be the expression 2x squared plus 7x plus 5. And now to find this sum, we want to think of clearing the parentheses. To do this, we can think of putting a positive 1 in front of each set of parentheses and distributing. But of course, distributing a positive 1 is not going to change the sign of any of the terms. So this would just be 3x minus 6 plus 2x squared plus 7x plus 5. And now we need to combine like terms. And we'll start with the highest degree terms first. There's only one x squared term. We have 2x squared. There are two x terms. We have 3x plus 7x, that's plus 10x. And we have two constants. We have negative 6 plus 5, which is negative 1. So we have minus 1. Notice the sum of these two functions results in another function in terms of x. Next we have f of x minus g of x. So we have the quantity 3x minus 6 minus the quantity 2x squared plus 7x plus 5. Again, to find this difference, we want to think of clearing the parentheses. So we'll put a 1 here and a 1 here. When we distribute this first one, it will not change the sign of either term. But here, because we're subtracting, we want to think of distributing a negative 1, which will change the sign of each term in the second set of parentheses. So here we have 3x minus 6, And then minus 2x squared, minus 7x, and then minus 5. And once again, combining like terms, we only have one x squared term. So we have negative 2x squared. Again, we have two x terms, but now it's going to be 3x minus 7x, which is negative 4x or minus 4x. And then we have two constants, negative 6 minus 5, that's negative 11. So we have minus 11. Our last example, we have g of x minus f of x. Notice here the order of the subtraction has changed, and since subtraction is not commutative, g of x minus f of x will not be the same as f of x minus g of x. Here we have g of x first, so we have the quantity 2x squared plus 7x plus 5 minus f of x, which is the quantity 3x minus 6. And now to clear the parentheses, we'll distribute a positive 1 here, and because of the subtraction, we'll think of distributing a negative 1. So when multiplying by a positive 1 here, the signs won't change. But because we're subtracting here, when we distribute negative 1, it will change the sign of each term. It'll be minus 3x and plus 6. Negative 1 times negative 6 is positive 6. Last step, combine like terms. We only have one x squared term, that's 2x squared. And then we have two x terms. We have 7x minus 3x, that's positive 4x or plus 4x. And then finally the constant terms, we have 5 plus 6, which is positive 11, so we have plus 11. So as you can see from these last two examples, we do have to be a little more careful when subtracting functions. I hope you found this helpful.